standing on the scale. The wheel is spinning. And it still weighs 91 kilograms. You've made your prediction. Let's see what happens when I throw it up over my head. In 3, 2, 1. What do you think?
I don't know about you, but to me it looked like a shaky mess. Let's watch that again in slow-mo, and I will graph the scale readings. As you can see, during the lift, the scale oscillates around 91 kilograms, the same as it read when I was stationary. So it seems the apparatus doesn't get heavier or lighter when it is lifted while spinning. The only large deviation from the average comes at the end of the lift, when I let the wheel fall so the scale reading drops, and then I slow its descent and so the scale reading rises. So the question remains, if the wheel doesn't get lighter, why does it feel lighter? This demonstration was first performed by Professor Eric Lathwaite. Listen to how he describes it.
So here goes 40 pounds of wheel, as light as a feather. This is not a conjuring trick, this is a fact of science.
He sure makes it look easy, doesn't he?
Watch it again carefully. A fact about a spinning wheel that so far everyone has missed.
Professor Lathwaite claimed the gyroscope's properties couldn't be fully explained by Newton's laws of motion. I disagree. But in order to understand why the wheel feels so light, we first have to consider why it feels heavy when it's not spinning.
So two-handed, that's as far down the shaft as you can hold it?
Yep.
Holding the shaft horizontally, you clearly need to provide an upward force equal to the downward weight of the wheel. But this is not enough, because with only these two forces, there would be a net torque causing the apparatus to rotate. So you need to create a counter torque in addition to supporting the weight of the wheel. This requires pushing down with one hand and pulling up with the other. And the upward force must be greater than the downward force by an amount equal to the weight of the wheel. So the force on each of your hands is significantly greater than the weight of the wheel. Now, once the wheel is spinning, the torque due to its weight now causes it to precess rather than fall to the ground. Therefore, no counter torque is necessary. You only need to supply an upward force equal to the wheel's weight, so it feels lighter. Now, the trick to lifting the wheel over your head is to push it forwards as you release it. Lathwaite knew this. If you force a gyroscope to precess faster, it lifts up.
Hurry the precession and it rises.
But the weight doesn't change.
Similarly, if you slow the precession of a gyroscope, it goes down.
Slow the precession and it falls dramatically.
I'll show it to you, Rod.
Yeah, show it to me.
It's hard to go back the way that it doesn't want to precess.
With two hands.
So you can't say it becomes as light as a feather when it's rising.
It certainly doesn't become as light as a feather. I can say that too, from having felt it. But it does feel lighter. And I think maybe part of that has to do with the fact that I'm not having to counter the torque with my hand. You know, all I have to do is support the weight of the disc, but I don't need to provide any torque with my hand to counter that gravitational torque, which is what makes it feel so awkward when you're trying to hold it when it's static.
When you apply a torque, as you were, then there's a force up on one side of the hand and down on the other side. And if you decrease the force on both sides, then it will actually feel lighter.
It feels lighter without actually getting lighter.
Yeah. What it does is to decrease the apparent weight that you're feeling.